Hello, everybody. Andrew Mayeska here with Dental L. So it is June the 1st, and I am getting ready to go back to work. I did upload a video a couple days ago, I think, but it's been very overwhelming because for some of you guys who are kind of following things closely, especially here in Ontario, we follow the CDHO. So that's the College of Dental Hygienists of Ontario. So that's kind of who we follow and who we have to listen to. But then there's the RCDSO, which I kind of RCDSO. RCDSO, that's the Dental Association. So that's who the dentists have to follow. And where things get difficult is when, or if you are a dental hygienist, as most of we are, we work for a dental office. So do you follow your hygiene association guidelines? The answer is yes. Or do you follow the Dental Association guidelines? And guess what? They're different. So there's some confusion where for those of you guys who are working in a dental office, certain things don't match up and you have to follow what your Dental Hygiene Association is suggesting, not what the Dental Association is suggesting. Because yes, you work for your boss, it's up to him, but you could get in a lot of trouble if you're not following yours. So I've been talking to a lot of hygienists, and there are a lot of hygienists who have decided not to go back to work yet until there's a clear fine line. Because as you can imagine, things can get very confusing, such as do we wear a gown or do we not wear a gown? There's talk about masks. Do we wear the N95 masks or do we wear the level 3 masks? I'm happy to say for once, mobile hygiene. If you are an independent dental hygienist, meaning you have your own practice, we don't work under a dentist. So it doesn't matter. I mean, it matters to me, but I follow the Dental Hygiene Association guidelines only, not the Dental Association guidelines, because I don't work for a dental office. So I don't have to worry about, oh, do I have to go to work and they don't have enough PPE for the Dental Association? You know, this might be okay, but we need this type of mask. So things can be very confusing. So that's one thing that I am happy to say. Just kind of in a nutshell, because this seems to be the most confusing, is what type of mask to wear. A level 3 mask is a lot more comfortable. I can't find an N95 mask anywhere, but that means that I'm not going to be doing anything that is creating spatter or aerosols, meaning I'm not going to use the ultrasonic polishing, things like that. I am going to wear a gown for every single patient, but even then it's kind of things might change by the time I do this video, but they're kind of saying, if you're not using the ultrasonic, you're not polishing, you're not using high-speed handpiece, you might not have to wear a gown. So there's a lot of things that are kind of confusing. The main thing for mobile is, and I don't know if I mentioned this in my last video or not, but we need to make sure to be wiping down our car. So like handles, our car handle, our steering wheel that we're obviously touching. If we're touching anything else, we need to wipe that down and we need to make sure to change out of our uniform per household. So that's something new. In your dental office or in your operatory, which this is mine, completely decluttered right now. Of course, I have the dogs just hanging out now, but that would not be happening if I was expecting a patient today. We are supposed to see one patient every 3 hours unless we have certain air filtration systems and all of that. HVAC systems, I think they talked about too. So the nice thing about me being mobile is I don't have to worry about the 3 hour window because I'm going to other houses. It's usually about 3 hours in between anyway, because when I clean patients' teeth, it's about an hour and 15 minutes for a new patient, but then there's 20 minutes setup time for mobile and 20 minutes tear down. It's probably going to take longer now because I'll need to change out of a new uniform. I'll be wearing a mask at all times. And then when I start treatment, I'll be in the full like PPE, like mask, loops, shield, hair cap, gown, the whole works. But I'll let you guys know, I haven't started working yet because I'm just kind of getting my puzzle pieces of a schedule together, because that's trickier when you're mobile because you're going to certain cities, right? Certain cities on different days. So I'm just kind of working that out. But when I start working, I will let you guys know how that went, my thoughts, and I'll go from there. Okay. Let me know though if you guys have any questions. I am very, very happy to help as always. And I'll see you guys in the next one.